Rebound relationships, they're just no good for anybody involved, for the person who's doing the rebounding, and for the person who's the rebound. Someone mentioned to me that there's a lot of videos out there about like why rebound relationships don't work, but what do you do when you're the rebound and you're trying to recover because your ex has broken up with you and you found out that you were actually a rebound and maybe that's why? How do you heal from that? That's a shitty situation to be in. It's funny because I got to thinking about this and my last ex that had the 6-year relationship with me, he was actually rebounding with me, and I didn't find that out until the end of the relationship, so it didn't really affect me that much. But when I did find out that I was a rebound and he only spent about 3 weeks between the last person he was with who he was engaged to and me, I did have some feelings about that. For one thing, it's like, hello, was our entire relationship a lie? Because I wasn't aware of this. And then there's the matter of like, well, what does that say about me? Why did I get into a relationship with somebody who wasn't over somebody else, and how did I not notice that? I had questions, and I had questions about my ex, I had questions about myself, and I wasn't gonna get them answered, so I had to kind of fill in the blanks and figure out things on my own. And I'm gonna share with you the things that I think you need to know about a rebound when you're a rebound, and what you need to do to move on, because these questions can nag at you and nag at you and nag at you. I know, because I was there. You don't need all the questions, you can move on. So first things first, I want you to understand that being a rebound has no reflection on you. There's nothing that you could have like done to know that this was a rebound, that it was going to become a rebound. There's no special signs. You know, when I look back to the beginning of the relationship with my ex, there was a mention of the ex before, but the way that he talked about it, I thought that this was like months ago, like it had been resolved and it was something that he worked on. Not true. It was only 3 weeks, and I feel like even if I asked him like how long was it and got a straight answer, it would have been a lie. It wouldn't have been a straight answer. I feel like even if you did know that it had been such a short time, you probably had your hopes in having a good relationship with this person, and they probably told you a lot of stories about how they were ready for a relationship. Usually not true if it's a rebound relationship, but we try to believe them because it's what we want. Maybe they came to us in a stage in life where we were feeling lonely, where we were feeling weak. Maybe not. With my ex, I was actually in a pretty confident place, and it just happened to be that he presented himself as somebody that I could trust, and there were signs, and I ignored them because he wasn't like everybody else. Like everybody else, I don't know if you've seen the dating pool lately. I'm sure you have. Everybody else in the dating pool, generally, like bottom level, like they have no standards, no boundaries, nothing. So here was somebody who was willing to have a conversation with me, who was willing to be semi-respectful, and I believed it. What I'm really trying to stress here though is that everybody wants things to work out. When a relationship starts, then it's normal to overlook things, so don't feel like there was something that you could have done. Now that you've gone through this experience, maybe with the next person you'll be a little bit more cautious, and maybe that's the lesson for you to learn. I don't know. It's okay to miss things. It's okay. It's not your fault that your ex decided to not disclose information to you or to make things not appear as they were. What I'm trying to say is that you don't have to beat yourself up over things that you didn't have control over. You don't have to keep replaying it over and over in your mind trying to figure it out. It's okay. Now, along with that, usually, even if you get past all of that, you still have this feeling of like, well, I feel like such an idiot. I feel so low. I feel like I was used, like relationships don't mean anything anymore, because how could this person who I trusted and who I loved take advantage of that trust, and how can I know that somebody else is going to do that too? Oh, I can relate to this so much. I still haven't seen anybody that I would consider like a real date since my ex left in 2016, the end of 2016, so I get that feeling of not feeling like you can trust anybody. You don't need to get back into a relationship so quickly, otherwise you'll just be getting into another rebound, so it's okay if it takes a while. When we bond with somebody, oxytocin plays a role. This is a hormone in our bodies, and what it does, we don't know everything that it does, but one thing that it does is it helps us to feel more confident, and we have higher self-esteem when we're bonded to somebody. So when our ex leaves us, especially after a rebound and we've got all these questions running through our head, we have this low self-confidence and we don't feel good about ourselves. And so it's normal to not trust people when you don't feel good in yourself. You almost feel like you can't trust yourself. Now, oxytocin isn't just limited to romantic relationships. It comes out when you spend time with people that you like, people who appreciate you, people who validate you, that you have a good time with, you experience joy with. So finding friends, using friends that you already have, not using them, but, you know, hanging out with friends and enjoying their company will start to boost your confidence a little bit, as long as they validate you, as long as they understand that this is a hard time that you're going through, and they respect that it's something difficult that you're dealing with. So getting out there with friends that you already have, maybe meeting some new friends, going online, maybe finding some anonymous friends who've been through this before, if it's hard to find people that you can relate to in person, all of that will help you to start healing. Spending time among people who make you feel good and doing things that make you feel good will start to build back that self-esteem and that confidence, and you'll start to feel like you can trust yourself again, and then you'll trust yourself to make the right decision on whether it's time to date somebody or not. Let's also talk about those feelings that you have about your ex, all of the anger from the betrayal, all of the frustration, and also the sadness because you believed in a relationship that was what you may consider to be a lie. I think one thing that we have to do is use caution here and not just believe automatically that your ex lied to you about everything. Maybe they really did have feelings for you, and maybe there really was love, and maybe they were trying to make this work. For some of you, maybe hearing that will be comforting. For some of you, maybe that'll just make you more angry. I don't know, but I think it's good to keep a perspective that's a little bit realistic about what's going on. Not to just channel all of our anger in one direction or all of our sadness in one direction, whether that be inward or outward, because that keeps us stuck. I mean, after a rebound, you're going to feel a lot of the normal feelings when a breakup happens, the loss and the grief and the panic and the freaking out and all the anger and the sadness and everything else. But there's this extra component that's similar to infidelity, where you were betrayed, where you put a lot of trust in somebody, and it probably feels like it was yanked away, like all of a sudden, all at once, when you found out that this was a rebound. And betrayal will definitely send you into a panic and a freak out. And that's sometimes why we try to seek out all these answers to questions that we don't really need to know the answer to. You know, I don't have all the answers to why my ex did the things that he did. And I've come up with a lot of the conclusions for myself, and maybe that'll help you. It helped me a little bit to kind of like think things through and be like, okay, this is probably what happened. But I didn't need the full answer to move on. Getting out of that panic space is what's going to help you to move on. So sitting in the panic and experiencing it and just being like, ah, this really sucks and I don't have an answer, and not trying to escape it through finding an answer, that will help. And it also helps when you're not out with your friends and you're not enjoying time and building your confidence back up, and you're not angry and seething and wanting to get revenge and all of those thoughts that run through your head, to have those moments where you acknowledge, wow, this really sucks. Right now, my life really sucks. I don't like it. I'm not happy. I'm sad. And just sit with it and cry. Be upset. Maybe a trusted friend can validate you and sit with you. I needed that. All right, I've gone through a lot here. I tend to just kind of like spray information out there and hope that something sticks and something helps you. Did anything help you? Is there any more questions you have about this? Let me know down below.